much does this cost me?
Oh, maybe a ride on the carousel.
Okay.
One pass.
I can handle that.
Can you do one? Okay.
I can handle that one.
Hey, guys. We just went to Ian Auden's. We're getting ready to do that truck. And look who showed up here. Have Harry Benjamin, the legend. And you guys saw in some pictures earlier of us bringing this back from Haver, from Big Equipment in Haver. This is the big bud that was burnt in that fire. It's been through two fires. And Harry here is the original designer of it.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
I built the first one in 1971.
Okay.
It's a model of the first big bud that was ever made. It's called a 250, NH, I think it's 250.
Yep. And, HN250, yeah.
It had all the decals on it and everything. It got burned up in a fire back, where was it? I don't remember where, but it their shop burned down,
mm-hmm.
and this big bud got burned up. And I went down and dug it out of the ashes. It looked just like, well, worse than it is right now.
Yeah.
And I took it home and sandblasted it and repainted it.
Oh, wow.
And put new decals on it and give it back to them.
Did you make the decals or did you have them made?
Well, I had them made.
Okay.
You can get decals made.
Yeah.
Including the instrument panel and everything.
You
can make that out of decals. And then this one got burned up again last winter.
Oh, wow.
In the same shop.
Oh.
A big bud shop in Haver. And there are several other big buds models sitting over here too.
Okay.
Went through the same fire.
Did you make those too?
No.
Oh, okay.
Those were factory.
Oh, okay.
Well, the boys in
William Brothers? Yep.
They made those. Well, they had them made. They're cast.
Okay.
But they're all melted down. They went through the same fire, but they're all just a pile of aluminum.
But yours withstood it.
This one's steel, so that makes this one a little more valuable.
And you built this in your shop out on the farm?
Yeah. This one?
Yes.
Yeah, I did. I cut out 10 of them.
Okay.
And I built one, and that went to Willie Hensley.
Okay.
Is that right?
Yep.
And then I built another one for myself.
Oh, wow.
I got 10 of them cut out, parts of them cut out. So I got one in my office at home.
Okay.
It'd be the mate to this one.
Oh, that's
awesome. And then I got a bunch of them cut out, but.
So you've got a blueprint. You've got one that's finished you can go back to and look at and say, that's what I need to do.
Yeah, right, yeah.
But this one's special because this one was a gift to Big Bud.
To Big Bud, yeah.
And it's been at their place this whole time, but wow, that's amazing.
Yeah.
Well, that's really neat, Harry. And you just have... picked Ian to do some sandblasting and paint work to it?
Yeah, I'm so busy with the carousel that I run out of time.
Oh,
I'm getting older, I take more sleep to keep I gotta have a nap after lunch every day, and I'm wearing out.
Well, that's understandable.
So I got him, and he's done quite a bit of work for me on my my carousel.
Mm-hmm.
On the horses, he put a clear coat on all my horses, all the images on the carousel.
Well, word is Ian does good work, so that's why we're coming to him too.
Perfection, right.
Yeah. Well, this is really cool, Harry. A lot of people really like what you do, and you know, I think this is something that people are going to enjoy seeing.
Well, it's been
a
fun job, I'll tell you.
Oh,
especially going through the fire and then. Fixing up and looking at it again.
And
it gets prettier every time. You get to put a little more detail on the decals, you know.
Yep.
A little better.
No, that's
so
great.
It's been a fun job.
Oh yeah.
All the way through.
Oh, that's exciting.
I should. I made two of these.
Okay.
I made a Wagner. That was the first one. I made a Wagner.
Okay.
And then I made a John Deere Wagner.
Oh,
remember when they got in a lawsuit with John Deere?
Yep.
And John Deere settled it by taking all their production from the Wagner out in Portland.
Oh, yes, yep.
For a while.
Yep.
And so I made a model of that John Deere Wagner.
Oh.
It's the same same, basically the same as a Wagner.
Is that a WA-17?
The front is more square.
Just yeah, little narrower fenders, I think they had on them.
Minor changes, yeah.
But green.
Yeah, green. And they're worth quite a bit now.
Oh, I bet, yeah. There's only a few of them made. They're pretty rare.
Well, I got one, and I give it to Dwayne. He was my John Deere dealer at Conrad.
Okay.
And I bought a lot of stuff through Dwayne. He always treated
me. Oh, so he's got one of those models.
He got one. I give that to him. Didn't charge him a thing, because he'd done favors for me. And I told him I'd like to have that back if you ever decide to get that. And he sold it to a collector back east.
Somewhere. Oh, he did?
Yeah, he sold it. So it's out of this. It's back in Illinois or somewhere. I don't know where.
Oh, that's too bad.
But it's the only one of its kind. It's probably worth 10 times more than this one even.
Well.
Because it's the only one.
Yeah, the only one ever made, especially by Harry himself.
Well, thank you.
Well,
thank
Harry, it's been a pleasure talking to you. And we'll watch the progress of this get redone. And then maybe I'll come talk again when it's finished up. And
That'd be fun.
Go from there.
That'd be fun.
And then we're going to go to your carousel, too.
Yeah, I think
people want to see that.
That's for sure.
So, yeah. Well, maybe my little girl, Rosie, will want to come ride. Well, cool, Harry.
Thank
All right,
you.
We'll catch you later.
Thank you.